30, number of flows. In Power Automate, every user can have up to 600 flows per user, and in each one of these flows, you can put up to 500 actions. Now, that's a lot of flows and a lot of actions. 29, CSV to Excel. To convert a CSV file to Excel, open the file and then save the file in a new Excel workbook using the Save Document as option in the Close Excel action. 28, Stop Running Process. Now, if you wanted to stop a process that is running on your environment, you can stop it using a hotkey. You can select the hotkey from your settings from the Power Automate desktop pane. 27, Add Comments to a Flow. Adding comments in Power Automate desktop is very easy. It's not going to only allow you to keep things tidy, but it's also going to allow you to separate actions inside of your flows. 26, Add Multiple Selectors. Adding multiple selectors is going to allow you to save a lot of development steps. You can add different selectors within the same UI elements in Power Automate. 25, Use Tolerance for Recording Images. Using tolerance for recording images is going to allow you to make your images easier to find by Power Automate, and therefore it's going to allow you to build stronger processes. 24, Export Machine Logs. If you go to Help and Preview Troubleshoot, you will be able to export the machine logs of your Power Automate desktop and understand exactly what is happening with your robots. 23, Export Your Flows. From the Solution tab in Power Automate, you will be able to export any of your processes, either from the different dev environments, example from the test environment to production, or to different accounts. You can export your Power Automate desktop or cloud flows or business process flows or any other type of process. Solutions also give you the ability to export all related components of your flows. 22. Delay Speed. Changing the default delay speed of 100 milliseconds to 500 milliseconds, for example, is going to make your processes more stable when you're developing and also more stable in execution. 21. Rename Elements. A quick and easy way to rename all of your UI elements is by using F2 shortcut. This will allow you to keep things tidy.
20. Reserved Keywords. A certain amount of words are being used in the core of Power Automate Desktop and can be used during development in the variables, subflow, label, or error block names. 19. Image Recorder. To use the image recorder, make sure you're running the latest version of Power Automate Desktop. The image recorder is not available for web recording, it is only available for your desktop recording processes. It is very easy to turn on once you're running desktop recording. 18. Scroll on web page. Sometimes it can be pretty hard to scroll on a web page. Many pages are dynamic and load the content automatically. Therefore, it is important to scroll on the web page. There's different ways to do it. One of the easiest ways is to use JavaScript. So if you launch a run JavaScript function on the web and paste in this code, you will be able to scroll on any web page. 17. Send keys. Sometimes inputting text in a web application or a software will not work. As a solution, you can use the send keys. The send keys action sends keystrokes to the application that is currently active. It can either be sent in the background as a software input or can be mimicked like from a keyboard when sent as hardware keys. 16. Focus window. Use focus window when you're having problems interacting with spied UI elements. However, sometimes depending on the nature of the app, a focus window action may not be able to bring the window into focus. In this case, send a click to the window and then use the focus to solve this.
15. Update Power Automate. Update Power Automate often as it's under a lot of development. If you have versions that does not have an update button, you will not be able to update automatically from the settings menu, but you will have to download the latest version instead.
14. Startup variables. If you want to build a process that has the ability to collect user input at process start, then you can add input variables to your flows. This will make it so that when you start your process, you will be prompted with a pop-up asking you to input information necessary for you to run the process. You have just created successfully a human-in-the-loop process.
13. Switch from gateways. You should switch from gateway connectivity to machines. In version 2.8 and newer versions of Power Automate, machines are replacing gateway connectivity. To set up machines, you don't need to install a gateway anymore, but from Power Automate Desktop, configure and set up your machine. 12. Monitor desktop flow runs. If you log into Power Automate Cloud Portal and go to the Monitor tab and the Desktop Flow tab, you will be able to see all of your desktop flow runs. You will be able to see some basic information like the execution of the process. If you click inside of each one of your executed processes, you will be able to see information about that process, all the different actions that were executed, and also the data that was used and collected during the flow. Unattended flow run. If you want to build an unattended robot in Power Automate Desktop, we need to start in Power Automate Cloud and create a scheduled flow. In other words, a scheduled flow is a robot that will run at specific times and date with specific intervals. The next step we need to do is add an action that will connect our cloud flow to our machine and subsequently to the flow that we want to run. Once we have done this, we would have created an unattended robot. 10. Screen resolution. When you capture images in Power Automate Desktop, the stored images are affected by the computer's screen resolution and DPI scaling. Before using image recognition, ensure the DPI scaling stays the same among the screens. Otherwise, your flows will probably fail. To achieve this, you can use the Set Screen Resolution action to change the screen resolution of the target machines. The new resolution has to be the same as the source machines from which the image was captured. To find the resolution of the source machine, use the Get Screen Resolution action or check the Windows Display settings. 9. Run SQL queries on Excel. Excel actions in Power Automate Desktop can handle most Excel automation scenarios. However, SQL queries can retrieve and manipulate significant amounts of Excel data more efficiently. Instead of using loops, conditionals, and multiple Excel actions, you can implement only two actions, the Open SQL Connection action and the Execute SQL Statement action. 8. Keyboard shortcuts. Many desktop applications provide keyboard shortcuts that make multi-step tasks easy and fast to perform. Power Automate Desktop allows you to apply these shortcuts to create shorter and less complicated flows. You can achieve this by using Send Keys. Before sending keystrokes to an application, however, make sure that you use Focus Window action to activate the window and make sure that you are sending the keystrokes to the correct application. 7. Identify a window. It's common in flow development to create flows that use several windows with the same title and class. Power Automate Desktop enables users to distinguish identical windows using handles. Handles are numbers that uniquely identify each window. To retrieve the handle of a window, launch the application with the Run Application action and set the After Application Launch drop-down menu to Wait for application to load. The handle is stored by default in the variable named Window Handle. 6. Extract text from Word. You can use OCR to extract text from Word documents, however this approach can become complicated for multi-page documents that require scrolling. A more efficient way to extract text from Word documents is to use VBScript. Power Automate Desktop provides the Run VBScript action that enables you to run scripts on your desktop. 5. Navigate instead of clicking. If you want to save development steps and building actions that could fail if the layout of the navigation changes, instead of clicking through the menu of the web page and building all of the required actions, navigate directly to the link that you need to access. You can use the Go to Web Page action in Microsoft Power Automate Desktop to go back and forward and to navigate to new URLs. 4. Use message boxes. In attended automation, interaction between the user and the workstation is necessary. Therefore, you can use message boxes and dialogue to collect input from the user and create even better flows. For example, you can allow the user to upload a file with the action Display Select File dialog. You can collect free text from the user with Display Input dialog, and you can also display a message and ask the user for approval. To do this, use the simple Display Message. 3. Process Advisor. Having installed Microsoft Power Automate Desktop will allow you to use Process Advisor to record the processes you wish to analyze. The Process Advisor can surface insight about time-consuming processes across your organization. Ideally, the processes that demand the most manual time and resources should be automated. This is how it works. Step 1, you identify and create the process about which you want to gain insight. Step 2, you invite colleagues to collaborate and add new recordings.
Step 3. You record the actions either you or your colleagues take to complete the process at hand. Step 4. You remove sensitive information, then group your actions into meaningful activities. Step 5. You generate a process map where you can analyze it and get insight. Key insight included how many people recorded the task, the average time it takes to complete the task, how many different paths the user took, and so on. 2. Evil robots. Robots can very easily hide malicious code that can do anything from changing machine settings and privileges to installing scripts and deleting files. There is currently no antivirus against robots or security measure except us. If we want to download or receive an automation, we should always make sure of how it works, but especially keep an eye out and a lookout for the following actions. Set service, set window environment variable, ping, run VBS script and any script, run DOS command, and run application. 1. Learn. Congratulations, RPA Champion, for making it to first place. I have shared my top 30 tips with you, a fellow automation enthusiast, and also that I like to call RPA Champion. In first place, I want to show you how you can exponentially become better at Power Automate, and this is by using the official Power Automate resources accessible from your Power Automate desktop under the Help in the settings. You will have access to the documentation, where you will find different guides, insight, ideas, and answers to many different questions you might have. There is also the learning library, and this is a set of tutorials that cover pretty much all aspects of the solutions and how to get started with the different components. There is also a community, which is very active, and if you're looking for to solve a specific issue, it's the perfect place. There is also many webinars available on the Microsoft website, and I will be sharing different links for all of these resources that are not available already on Power Automate in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget, F subscribing, start automating.